It's a touchstone. You know what's a touchstone? Anything you touch with that touchstone, that thing becomes like that touchstone. Have you heard of that story of King Midas? Midas or Midas? How do they pronounce it? I think it's Midas.
Midas.
I'm sorry. He got this benediction from this angel. This angel was very pleased with him and asked him, "What do you want?" He said, "I want a benediction. Whatever I touch becomes gold." She said, "So be it." He was so excited. Wow. He touched the table. Gold. Touched the chair. Gold. Everything. He sat down to eat. Touched the glass. Gold. Now there was a problem. The minute his tongue touched the water, it became gold. He's touching the food, it's becoming gold. Problem. Finally, he touched his daughter and she became gold. He had to run back to that angel. Sorry, I don't want this benediction. Please, can you reverse it back? So be it. Everything came back to its normal. So, similarly, we have to be very careful. This holy name is Chintamani. It's a touchstone. Anybody that comes in contact with this holy name, the scriptures establish, we'll see one beautiful verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, will get some purification. They may not get the ultimate benefit. Again, as we said, because it's Chaitanya, it's conscious, however you'll approach it, you'll get that benefit. But you will get some benefit. Because it's a touchstone. There is this beautiful verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam spoken by Yamaraj to the Yamadutas in the pastime of Ajamu. The Yamadutas asked Yamaraj, this Ajamu was a sinner. He sinned all his life. And here it is at the last moment, once he chants Narayan, and we have no authority to take him. You are telling us to let him go. No, let the Vishnu Dutas take him. What is this? Then Yamaraj explains to Yamadutas the potency of the holy name. In that beautiful verse, he tells to Vishnu, his Yamadutas, that anybody who chants the holy name, anybody, in whatever state, he gives four different situations where a person can chant the holy name. How they can chant? He says, Sanketyam. Sanketyam means this person does not chant the holy name directly. Like I'll give you an example. Suppose I'm coming in a car and I'm at a traffic light and another car stops by and that car person pulls down the window and asks me, "Excuse me, can you tell me where's the Hare Krishna temple?" I'm not a devotee. I know nothing about Hare Krishna. I don't chant Hare Krishna. Only thing is I know where is the Hare Krishna temple. So I tell this person, take the first left, on the first corner is the Hare Krishna temple. That's all. Now, this person, he didn't chant Hare Krishna. He just gave directions to this person to reach the Hare Krishna temple. He just told him at the next corner is the Hare Krishna temple. Sanketyam. Yamaraj says, this person gets a benefit. And what's the benefit? At the end of the verse, he says, what is the benefit? He didn't chant directly, he just chanted it indirectly. He'll get benefit. What is the next? He says, Parihasyam. If a person chants the name of Krishna even once, jokingly. Just jokingly means, he doesn't want... A lot of us are from India, right? You know, in 1970s, when this Hare Krishna movement was at its peak, it was like wildfire spreading everywhere. There was this very famous director in India who made a movie. He wanted to take advantage of this Hare Krishna movement in a very negative way. So, some of you all know which movie it was, we don't want to go into that. But he made a song. And this song became very popular. And in this song, actually, he is ridiculing the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. He is making fun of it. Right? Everybody knows that. Dham walo dham, kushi hoya gam, bolo subah sham, Hare Krishna Hare Rama. He was making fun of that holy name. And when the devotees heard in India, they were very upset. They went to Prabhupada. What is this? They are ridiculing our whole movement. Prabhupada was not upset. He said, they will all get benefit of chanting that holy name. Jokingly, so many times people make fun of us, Hare Krishnas, right? Oh, you know those Hare Krishnas, they look so funny with that shaved head and a ponytail and I don't know what all these Hare Krishnas do. They are getting benefit. What is the third? Stobham. Stobham means the exact translation in Bhagavatam Prabhupada gives is for musical entertainment. You know, a lot of people, when we are playing, when sometimes we go to Five Points, they don't even know what's this holy name, what we are chanting. Somebody might just bring a guitar and, you know, start chanting. They won't even chant, they'll just stand there and, you know, participate in the kirtan. Either hearing, or if they know just one word of that Mahamantra, they might say Krishna or Rama or Hare or something. For musical entertainment. And what is the fourth one? Helanam. Neglectfully. Just, you know, he doesn't want to chant, but he just, I'll give you an example of this. See, my name happens to be Ram. Right? Now in my office, all the time when I'm approached by anybody, how do they approach me? Hey Ram, have you done this? Hey Ram, is the document ready? And I'm telling you, when I read this verse, I was thinking, all these people are getting benefit. Not because they're chanting my name or something, they're chanting the Lord's name. Hey Ram, imagine. In India, that's regarded as highest. People, when if you're dying, they tell them, chant, Hey Ram, Hey Ram. And here they're chanting 24 hours, Hey Ram. All the time in the office, they're saying, Hey Ram. Hey Ram. They're not chanting consciously. Neglectfully also, if a person chants it. What happens? Asesa agaharam. All of these four conditions, when this person chants the holy name, do you know what happens? Unlimited. He's not talking of one. Asesa means unlimited. Agaharam. Unlimited sinful reactions of this person are dissipated. Can you believe it? This is the holy name. It's Chintamani, you just have to come and touch. Make a person chant Krishna's name once anyhow, he gets the right. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once asked Haridas Thakur, I am so disturbed. Haridas Thakur said, why? He said, I have come, my objective is to deliver everybody by chanting the holy name. But here there is a certain class of people, and he was meaning to the Muslims. They don't chant. How will I deliver them? Haridas Thakur said, they are already delivered. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, what do you mean? He said, my dear Lord, do you know these Muslims, from morning to evening to night, they are all the time repeating one word. What is that word? Haram. You know, in Hindi we say harami, some of you are maybe knowing, it comes from this Urdu word haram. So these Muslims, in slang, it's a slang word actually, they keep, you know, haram means a wicked person. So they, in that slang way, whole day they are chanting haram, haram, haram. And Haridas Thakur told Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, actually in that haram is Ram. So they are getting benefit. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so pleased, he embraced Haridas Thakur. He said, you are the Nam Acharya, because of that, you have the perfect understanding of the holy name. This is the holy name, Chintamani. And what is the last quality over there? It is Rasa Vigraha. See, in Brahma Samhita, how is Krishna described by Brahma? Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachid Ananda Vigraha. Right? Krishna is a form. God is a form. Right? And here, again in this Shastra, the holy name is also being addressed as a form. Holy name is not abstract, please. That is why a lot of you all may have heard, His Holiness Indradum Swami Maharaj, whenever he does kirtan, do you know how he ends? He'll do all jai jai jai, and then he ends with Harinam Prabhu ki jai. Because they have that realization that this holy name is a person. Sri Prahlad Prabhu also, whenever he ends his kirtan, he will always say Harinam Prabhu ki jai. It's a person. And this person, Harinam, holy name, is an embodiment of all rasas. What do you mean by rasa? See, we are living entities, right? We are Jivatma, that's our real identity. Every Jivatma has a relationship with Krishna. And this relationship is a unique relationship. My relationship with Krishna, this person's relationship with Krishna, all living entities' relationship with Krishna is unique. And when there is relationship, means what comes as a result of relationship? Reciprocation. Right? Loving reciprocation. When we love Krishna, Krishna reciprocates with us. And this reciprocation happens It's described by our acharyas in five different relationships, in five different rasas or mellows. What are these five? There are seven secondary rasas also. We'll just talk about the five primary rasas. The Santa ras means a ras of neutrality. Then you have the Dasya ras, the relationship in which you are the servant and Lord Krishna is the master. Hanumanji is the personification of that. Then you have the Sakya ras, friendship, where you and Krishna are friends. Arjuna is personification of that. Then you have the Vatsalya ras, where the devotee becomes the parent. Imagine Krishna takes the subordinate position. Yashoda Mai, Nand Maharaj, Vasudev, Devaki. And what is the last rasa? Madhurya, conjugal love. The residence of Vrindavan headed by Srimati Radha. Krishna becomes subordinate. So all these rasas are embodied in this holy name. That is why Prabhupada used to say, you simply chant Hare Krishna and everything will be revealed to you. You don't have to do anything separate from that. In the good old days, when these Western devotees were coming to India, there were a lot of these Babajis around Mayapur and Vrindavan who were trying to allure, trying to attract these Westerners to them. So they would tell our devotees, if you come to us, immediately, Prabhupada is taking so much time, immediately we will reveal your constitutional position in the spiritual world, who you are. You are a gopi or you are a cow or you are a peacock or whatever you are. And Prabhupada would say, just chant the holy name. This holy name from within will reveal to you everything. There is a beautiful pastime, this one devotee, he went to one Babaji one day. And next day morning, this devotee was seen sitting outside close to the window. It's Mangala Arati time, all the other devotees are telling him, it's Mangala Arati, let's go for Mangala Arati. He is not ready to go. What is he doing sitting at the window? He's sitting, seeing outside, and he's constantly with his neck, he's doing like this. So one devotee asked him, what happened? Do you have a sprain or something? He said, no, don't disturb me. So why? He said, yesterday this Babaji revealed to me that I am a peacock in the spiritual world. So I am practicing from now on. So word reached Prabhupada that this devotee went to somebody and it has been revealed to him that he is a peacock. How did Prabhupada react? Prabhupada just laughed. He said, I don't know whether he is a peacock or a cow or whatever he is in the spiritual world, but I know one thing for sure. If he continues to do what he is doing, he will definitely become a peacock. Not in the spiritual world, in the material world. These are Prabhupada's words. You don't have to do that. This holy name will reveal it to you. Bhaktisiddhanta Swami Thakur said the same thing. Our Siddha Pranali is this. Trinadapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahashuna Amanina Manidena Kirtanya Sada. Just chant the holy name always. In this mood, the holy name will reveal everything to you. You don't have to do anything separate. This is holy name. Six qualities. Every day when we chant, if we just meditate on this one verse, you'll feel, you'll see the reciprocation coming from the